1985, when I was just getting out of college, 24 years ago, the person who built this rather large house in exchange for a permit from the public commission to do that granted an access way on the side of her house in between these two houses. Now, in order for an access way to actually become one, after it's what we call dedicated, some public or private entity has to accept it and become basically the entity that manages it, develops and manages it. That actually happened too long after, 18 years later, in what was that, 2003, and it was actually done by Access for All, which is actually a private nonprofit advocate for public access down here. And what they found out is that in between, in those 18 years, the homeowner had built a few things inside the access way. So what do you guys see on the edge of that property?
They didn't invent it for you, and it's for
now. No, it's actually the access way.
Basketball court.
It's kind of hard to see. We're not that
Hedge.
Okay. Oh, a fence.
Yeah. A fence.
A big fence.
Some lights.
Okay.
Basketball.
Guard dog on duty. Hopefully not guard dog. So, in fact, what we have in that access way is a 9-foot wall, a hedge, a concrete slab, a lights, in fact, a whole lighting system, planters, a fence, and big rocks. So, basically, in order to use that access way at the moment, you would need basically like a ladder, rock climbing equipment, and a machete. Okay, it's basically completely blocked. Okay? So in 2005, the Coastal Commission ordered them to remove all of that stuff so that we can open the access way. At which point, a subspecies of Homo sapiens, that they could not mention, Homo litigatus, became very active and started sending out all kinds of alarm calls. And they're basically the standard alarm calls that happen in the course of the creation of an access way. It's not a good place for an access way. That place is much better. You should go up there. It's not safe for the public. There's no trash cans. There's no bathrooms. There's no lifeguards. These are all the standard things. And really, why don't you use that place up there? That's much better. And this neighbor over here in 2006 filed a suit to prevent the opening of the access way. That took 2 years. You guys still with me? We got 3 years to go. It's 3 years, okay?
Wow.
We're almost there. At which point, he lost that access suit in 2008, which is when they offered to actually give the state a whole bunch of money to put that place up there instead of over here. At the same time, they're arguing over the lateral easement, which they also have a lot of illegal development in because it's nice little double-sized rocks that you see that they put there. And finally, in July 2009, so a month ago, basically, issued a cease and desist order to this homeowner to remove all this development so that we can open the access way, which of course has been followed by a cascade of leading lawsuits. So we will see. We think we're getting a lot closer. We're not at the point yet where it's supposed to happen. We're supposed to have 30 days to come up with a plan to do that, but I think that's now in limbo until those lawsuits. Basically, what happens is that has been happening down here in the last 5 years. Where they're not winning, but in some ways they're not winning because what's happening is these access ways and all these other issues get tied up in litigation so long that it ties up the public commission resources and handicaps and all bunch of this, you know, so they can't get rid of the 300 illegal private property signs because this is a more important fight. So they're kind of losing each of the legal battles, but they, you know, the battles take so long that in some ways that's the problem. Not that we aren't able to mention it. One final thing. The reason verticals, these are called vertical access ways as opposed to the ones we've been using, which are laterals. We call them dry sand easements, but that's just what we call them. There was a lawsuit that went against the state in the late 1980s that basically said that these requests requiring homeowners to do the vertical access ways was too high a standard.